happy Thursday, everybody. We're finally here, almost the end of the week. Thank God, thank God, thank God, right? Tomorrow is definitely TGIF. It has definitely been a week, and I'm ready for the weekend. So, you guys know how every day this week I just keep talking about what's been happening with Wendy Williams. Well, yesterday, it looks like Wendy, not only as I told you that she fired her husband from the show, it looks like the mistress had a Maserati or something like this that her husband had bought for the mistress. Anyway, supposedly Wendy had it towed. She took the car back. So good for you, Wendy. She's taken all those steps. And now also, you know, Wendy used to have a show with Charlamagne. It seems like they had a feud. I don't know what the feud was about. I don't know all the details. But anyway, yesterday they made amends after 10 years. I think it did have something to do with Wendy's husband. So it looks like Wendy and Charlamagne, you never know what could happen. They might be in the works for getting together and teaming up again. You never know. So shout out again to Wendy. Also, I also want to remind you guys this weekend, the cornhole tournament. That will be at the Countryside Complex, and that is the fourth and fifth grade tournament. It'll be this Saturday from 10 to 7. So please go out and show your support. As for birthdays, if it is your birthday, happy birthday to you. And for celebrity birthdays, it looks like it is Kourtney Kardashian. Happy birthday, Kourtney. Conan O'Brien. He's a late night talk host. Happy birthday to Conan. And also, Siri Cruz, Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes' daughter. Happy birthday to you. All right, we will be right back in a few minutes with Mr. Page, and we are going to talk about TBOY, because today is TBOY Thursday. So stay tuned and stay focused. See you in a few.
Hey, we are Pretty Please on Broad, a classy and sassy ladies boutique located in the heart of downtown Alta Vista, Virginia and the worldwide interwebs. We focus on limited runs, unique fashion at affordable prices. Because as I like to say, no woman wants to show up to her event and do the who wore it better. We have recently added monogramming and embroidery services, and we can rock your fashion and help you personalize that either for your own personal items or for your small business. We focus on big city fashions, so we look at fashion from LA, from New Orleans, as we are a New Orleans inspired boutique, and we really try to focus on bringing in big city fashion without the big city price tag. So give us a call or shop us online at prettypleaseonbroad.com. Our number is 704-281-8748, and make sure to like us on Facebook and Instagram. See you at Pretty Please on Broad, located at 615 Broad Street, downtown Alta Vista, Virginia.
Who is N. Wesley Pugsley Jr. and Associates CPA?
We are a full-service CPA firm with over 25 years' experience in audit, tax, bookkeeping, payroll, including direct deposit, setting a 501c3 nonprofit status, preparing loan packages, and much more. We have an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau. When I started in public accounting in the early 1980s, there were no computers or fax machines. Everything was face-to-face meetings. With the advent of computers, the internet and cloud-based software, we can communicate with any client from anywhere in the country. With our portal technology, which is similar to online banking, you just sign into our secure website, upload your tax document, you scan to your C drive, and we prepare your return.
It appears times are changing.
I call this the year of enlightenment. Many Americans are seeing the advantages of supporting community-based businesses. We are here to serve you, not just because we're a community-based firm, but because we have the experience. We know we can serve your needs.
Pebble Ridge Farm. Our passion is to reach out to the underserved youth in our communities, transforming their lives through educational, cultural, and outdoor experiences. We build self-esteem through academic support and success. And with self-esteem comes the belief that our children can reach their dreams. At Apple Ridge Farm, our job is to see the amazing seeds of potential in our youth until they can see that in themselves. Children are our future, and Apple Ridge Farm is committed to continue helping kids grow. For more information, visit appleridge.org today.
We're back. And we have Tommy with us today. Hey, Tommy.
Well, hello, Erica. How are you?
I'm good. How you doing?
All is well in the kingdom.
Good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I thought you was having your phone to see who was in the room.
No, I wasn't going to do that.
It's just kind of as a thing that you do.
It's just a thing that I do. You know, you have your thing during your show. I have my thing during mine.
Oh, yeah.
That's what it is. And speaking of your show, you haven't done it in a little while. What's going on? When are you coming back?
Why are you bringing attention to that? Why are you doing that? That don't make sense. But anyway, it's because we've been making sure we're getting this Daily Grind show going. And we're really pushing real strong for this T-Boy. We want T-Boy to be well supported. T-Boy is very important for the overall goal of what we do. And our overall goal is just to open up opportunities. You know, the reality is that... You can't really make anyone do anything, but you can do what you can do. And if you do what you can do long enough, you'll be able to do some of the things that they say you couldn't be able to do.
Right.
Especially if you start getting teams, start getting more people to come and do a part of it. So I'm happy that after 6 years of us being down here, we can definitely see the influence of, you know, our whole mission has been to concentrate on opportunity through innovation. And so it's kind of great that, you know, Roanoke has this innovation corridor and then enterprise. You know, that's been our thing. So we, you know, in major cities that we've lived in, you know, that's what allows for them to be major cities. So Roanoke is still a hub of Southwest Virginia. So We just acting what the city's supposed to act like. That's all. So it's just been exciting, and definitely seeing others pick up, you know, and do the things that, you know, that we've already laid out there. So, you know, yeah.
So when you talk about opportunities, again, what opportunities are out there?
I think I read a book that I always reference, man. I love when Russell Simmons' book, Do You, man, and he speaks of white space. And white space just means it's the area where there's no real activity going on there. There's room to do that. And so when you listen to the cries of an area that, you know, are saying we don't have this or we don't have that, and then you look at the ability for those people, or the term that's used in business, the capacity for those to come out there and actually do it, you know, you now start seeing that we have a whole district. We got a whole borough, for so to speak. We got a whole Northwest corridor that if we just now put more energy into what we can do and what we have done other places and build up our area, you know, with the same concepts that we do elsewhere.
Right.
That's the opportunity. That's the simple opportunity. Sometimes it seems harder than that. It seems like we got to have the money. But the reality is that we get money from putting energy into other places, take that money and spend it over there as well, and come back to our area and expect something to happen without us doing it ourselves. You know? And I love T.I., man. T.I. On his last album, says no more begging for stuff we can do ourselves. We have very influential people. We got people who are making good money from the stuff that they're due. So all we have to do now is just redirect that to the energy of making sure we build up what we love. And all of us love Northwest Roanoke. I mean, I know I do. I'm 3005 Ferncliff born.
I mean, we always come back to it.
It's
so
here.
You gotta love it.
3005 Ferncliff born. Mom's still there right now. And I love this city as a whole. Mm-hmm. But I love where I'm from, too, because I love what it has added to the city. Mm-hmm. I love every section, and I love, and we do stuff in every quarter. We were just supporting a Southwest that also really heals the Southeast initiative this past week with Doc's Rock Fashion Show, mm-hmm. And helping them raise money. Right. And anybody who's been watching us, and even if you haven't, you've seen us show up and just about every effort that's going to raise money or get something going in Northwest, we there. Mm-hmm. And so now to be speaking about our own concert series, Cultural Arts Festival and Concert Series, mm-hmm. that the whole purpose is to bring business out first.
Right.
It's one thing we can hang out and do, that's cool. Mm-hmm. But now we want everybody to come down to Gainesboro mm-hmm. to get the Gainesboro experience, but more importantly, come and shop local with businesses you normally wouldn't have a chance to go shop with.
Exactly.
So that's the whole opportunity, that's the whole enterprise, and that's the innovation because nobody else is doing it.
True. Now, for those people out there that don't know, what is the Gainesboro experience?
The Gainesboro experience, man, now you hear people talk about and refer to the yard. Mm-hmm. And so I'm 45, so when I was younger coming down here, what a lot of people don't take into account is that it wasn't just here, Henry Street and everything like that.
Right.
It extended all the way down to 11th Street.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Down 11th Street, mm-hmm. where you know you came down 11th Street and just that whole section. And when I look at it now, when passing that, the only thing we really have active there, and I keep it real on shows, you know, that's why I've went tonight, so I don't, you know. The only thing we got active on those streets that is making money for us are two funeral homes on each end.
Right.
That's the only thing.
And that's sad.
That's just what
that's
really.
Sad,
I won't
though.
Say it's sad. I just say it's what's real.
It's good for them that they have that business,
yeah.
But it's sad.
Because that's true, because we're going to keep dying. But we're going to die.
That's what keeps happening.
But I hope we live in between, because now if you just go down a couple blocks, mm-hmm. you'll realize that in there, there's, and it's standing there. And I'm coming after that one, too. My homie, big shout out to Dr. Torino Jennings, a fireboy, too. He has an ambulatory service out of Richmond and
okay.
things like that. But there is the Huntington Life Saving Crew, mm-hmm. the building which had the America's mm-hmm. first black started, black staffed mm-hmm. ambulatory service.
Right.
That's there now, that's sitting there with no life in it. Mm-hmm. And we like, nah, we need to put some life back
we
in
need
it.
Life.
But in order to do that, we have to keep putting life into where we at here in the Lawson building. Mm-hmm. A lot of people don't know Southwest Virginia Development Fund used to have money in that time
right.
after urban renewal. We talk about urban renewal mm-hmm. and things like that. And
they had a fund for business.
They had a fund for businesses mm-hmm. and stuff to go up there. But let's say it's two parts of this thing every time.
Okay.
People will always say what hasn't been there and how they go get it. But a lot of times we don't take advantage of the opportunity. Mm-hmm. The fund has been there, and where others could have utilized it to really get behind and let their business mature and do something, mm-hmm. a lot of times didn't have the what it take to stay with it. Only other businesses that really did thrive were those that weren't necessarily from our community.
Mm-hmm.
And those businesses are what kept the fund alive.
Right.
But we're saying, hey, now that we got more information, and now that we can be able to have our voice heard before, mm-hmm. before someone changes what's said about what we're doing,
mm-hmm.
that's why we have a network, and that's why we say, now, hey, if we do it now, and they do it like they did before,
right.
We'll do it. But right now, I think everybody wants to do it together. So it's not even about that black and white thing. I think
it's
everybody wants to do
together.
It. Yeah, man.
It's about together. On that note, everybody, we'll be right back.
Hey, we are Pretty Please on Broad, a classy and sassy ladies boutique located in the heart of downtown Alta Vista, Virginia and the worldwide interwebs. We focus on limited runs, unique fashion at affordable prices. Because as I like to say, no woman wants to show up to her event and do the who wore it better. We have recently added monogramming and embroidery services, and we can rock your fashion and help you personalize that either for your own personal items or for your small business. We focus focus on big city fashions. So we look at fashion from LA, from New Orleans, as we are a New Orleans inspired boutique. And we really try to focus on bringing in big city fashion without the big city price tag. So give us a call or shop us online at prettypleaseonbroad.com. Our number is 704-281-8748. And make sure to like us on Facebook and Instagram. See you at Pretty Please on Broad, located at 615 Broad Street, downtown Alta Vista, Virginia.
Crying Out, Separation Anxiety and a Soldier's Child by Chardonnay. Aid your child in coping with separation anxiety with the help of one mother's personal experience with her own child crying out as he dealt with separation anxiety. The author Chardonnay has been immersed in the military her whole entire adult life. After growing up in their small town, she left to join the army. It became her passport to the whole world. She spent 6.5 years in the military, and after her commitment, she's proud to call Virginia home. She's also a wife and a mother of the one who motivated this book. Get your copy today by going to www.cryingout1.com.
I matter because I help people every day learn about their medications and their health, and I matter because I'm a human and every life matters.
We're back. Okay, Tommy.
Really? That's how you gonna do it? What?
I said you just gave us an earful. So, what? Okay. You know how a lot of people are scared to stay away from Gainesboro. It's a reality. Why do you think that is?
That they scared, they stay
away?
They
stay away from it. They don't see the potential. I don't understand that, because when I come, all I do see is the potential. But why is it some people are okay with leaving it like this?
I don't think it's so much leaving it like this, more so to say that because of, like I said, when I remember my tenure here before I left,
right,
that it was starting to, what others would say, go down.
Mm-hmm.
It now the reality of what urban renewal done, as far as taking the pride, mm-hmm, and the value of business out of here,
mm-hmm,
left it so that you have families who may have been on public assistance,
mm-hmm,
or who just really didn't have a drive to get in there anymore, that everyone else left. And so now, when you look at the people who have been here, to look at something that you watch go down,
mm-hmm,
it's hard for you to conceptualize it. Let us build it back up. But that's why I'm excited about.
But how, like, do you leave behind your roots?
But hold on, let me hold on.
I
agree. Let me see where I'm going with that.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I think it's beauty that you have people who do leave.
Mm-hmm.
When you got people who leave, now they can go and see other cities who have a similar type of thing, because this is something, urban renewal hit the whole country.
Oh yeah.
So therefore, oh, yeah, it's just been bigger cities has sped up the process in fixing that,
and
most of it, they didn't take care of it. What happened was gentrification came and made it something else.
Mm.
And so those who come back to that area would have to be better off,
mm-hmm,
or whatever, to even come back in there. And specifically, D.C. area, man. When you think about D.C. Right. area and the Navy Yard area, where, you know, what that used to be 20 years ago,
mm-hmm,
in comparison to what it is now,
mm-hmm,
And that's something that you just can't put on the system. You got to put it into the bigger picture, that in order for the country to thrive, because D.C. is still a hub of where people come from all over the world,
right,
to come live.
Mm-hmm.
And so you got people coming here that's got decent money, mm-hmm, from different places that can move into those built up areas.
Mm-hmm.
Because even though we might get images that all these other countries still look third world and stuff like that, man. When you go to Israel, you go to Dubai, mm-hmm. when you go to those places like that, mm-hmm. they are very advanced. Mm-hmm. So now people coming into this area, you got to now pick it up on the spaces that others have left behind. Right. And so we feel that it's very important, since we've seen that stuff and we got enough people with influence mm-hmm. that lives here in Roanoke, mm-hmm. that everybody can say, well, let us be an example of how you can build this thing up mm-hmm. without leaving anyone displaced, mm-hmm. with also fixing and correcting the issues that happen in urban renewal.
Right.
Because you can bypass that what happened with urban renewal and those things didn't have an effect on a whole community.
Oh,
you can't
sure.
you can't just overlook that.
Right.
But now I'm not trying to say just because of that, give it back to us type deal. No,
right.
I'm trying to say that if we work together,
we can take it back.
If we work together, we can take it back, mm-hmm. and we can be a part of the function thing, because we still should have a pride. Yes,
right.
there is a dark, terrible past mm-hmm. of what happened mm-hmm. To how the country initially really got its understanding of us.
Mm-hmm.
But the reality is the story goes more than that. We just don't hear that. There's black originals who were not slaves.
Right.
There are people, and just because you are of darker skin does not mean that you are from the African tribe the African tribes mm-hmm. that came here to be slaves.
Mm-hmm.
You could be Native American. It's, mm-hmm. it's a lot of things that now, while learning and fixing all that stuff,
mm-hmm.
we can now stop being so stuck back there and look at what we're doing presently today,
right?
What we've seen other cities do,
mm-hmm.
get excited about it,
mm-hmm.
put our money together, put our effort and our time into it, and just do what, because even though it may be tough for us in the time we're in now,
right,
we're going off of the stories of a people who now were less than 50 years removed
mm-hmm.
from being owned by somebody.
Mm.
They were slaves. When this area, when Gainsborough really got its prominence,
mm-hmm.
was in 1920s.
Mm-hmm.
And so if 1920s, and you say in 1865 is when, you know, when the Juneteenth happened.
Right.
Because we was let go in
63.
But
mm-hmm.
it didn't really happen. They was like, yeah, they might have signed it, but this slave thing is still working for
mm-hmm.
us. So that's why it took another 2 years, 2.5 years actually,
mm-hmm.
before it finally, and that's why we celebrate Juneteenth.
Right.
But these people coming by 1920 had established this area where you got doctors,
mm-hmm.
you got your own clinic,
mm-hmm.
you mean you got your own hospital,
mm-hmm.
you got your own barbershops,
mm-hmm.
you got your own retail district,
mm-hmm.
you got your own services, people, you have all of that. So that's what the T-Boy experience is going to be. It's not
mm-hmm.
going to be an event, it's going to be a recreation of some of the elements that were there then,
mm-hmm.
but what 100 years later looks like. Because we're going into 2020, 100 years later, with a lot more information,
mm-hmm.
a lot more innovation, a lot more access.
Right.
So now we can do it even better. And
even
I think the ancestors will be happy with that.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
And that's what it's about.
Yeah.
It's about the ancestors to
yeah.
me.
Yeah.
You know, it's not about anything else.
Yeah.
So what do you think is gonna be the difference this year from T-Boy last year? What can we look forward to?
I mean, everything is a building process, especially when, you know, I was just thinking, we always hear the term Rome wasn't built in a day.
No.
Why don't we talk about how Egypt and Kush and all them wasn't mm. built in a day either? But that's a whole different thing.
That's
a whole different thing. But no kingdom mm-hmm. was ever built in a day.
Mm-hmm.
And no resistance to a system was ever happened like that. But the beauty of it is, we are in a place where we have that white space.
Mm-hmm.
And that is, before we saying give us something else and everything that ain't occupied, we have three buildings right here.
Three.
We have the Lawson building,
mm-hmm.
we have the Clayton Clinic, and
mm-hmm.
the building we were operating out of. And
it used to be Moses Grove.
Moses Store.
Mm-hmm.
Are all still black owned.
Yes.
The beauty of it is we're happy because we feel we're the only entity that has shown capacity to be able to operate out of all three.
Mm-hmm.
And so we feel that if now a couple of other people who will take the same resilience that it has taken us to survive in this time, because if you don't get the support of your community, you normally die.
Right.
But we found a way to even while supporting our community mm-hmm. and may not have got the complete support back, mm-hmm. we still found a way to live. Mm-hmm. And so with that, we just thinking that everybody, if everybody just say now, we've done enough meetings. We've been meeting for years.
Right.
Let's stop meeting. Hey, they got to play on the field. Let's get behind them.
Mm-hmm.
And that will be whomever. Mm-hmm. As long as we get 5,000 people to come out and experience the concert series and the culture arts and shop with the different local people mm-hmm. That will actually come down here for that. And then if we got 10,000 people that will globally donate into this fund mm-hmm. so that those same businesses and things that we're working on will have that opportunity. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's a great thing. You got the Bank of Baditai that's going to hold it, who right. has now, you know, supported this event. You have yes. you have West Pugs mm-hmm. and Associates, 30-plus years of an A-plus rating and operating one of the businesses operating out of historic Gainesboro.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, their firm is going to maintain it and audit it. And then you have the partnership with CERCAP mm-hmm. is going to actually manage it through their entrepreneurship programs mm-hmm. and stuff and the partnerships we've been doing to be able to bless 10 businesses.
10 businesses.
With if they just stay in the program, man. So it's exciting, and it's going to be probably one of the best concert series that you've seen
in a while.
You haven't seen mm-hmm. a concert lineup like this. And like we may have had a one night. Or you haven't seen a lineup like we got. So we're excited.
Absolutely. So you want to touch, because we only have a few more minutes.
Do we? What are we looking like? I don't know what we got. I don't know. Oh, yeah? We only got a few more. Want to touch on who's coming? Is that what you're saying?
No.
What'd you say?
5'10".
5'10". That's the most important. I just kind of did. Everyone knows that my son passed. My son, John Anthony, well, if you don't know, he was everything to me. You know, I changed my whole life. And on the direction I was going, I left school and went to the military when he was born because we found out he had sickle cell and he needed real health care. That's the only reason why I went to the Navy. I had no other desires to go to the Navy. Let that be for anybody who didn't know. I was doing all right at Ferrum, playing football and baseball, and it was okay. But he's gone. He's gone, and we understand that he still is with us. And so we celebrate him each year and that we've done blood drives for the cause of sickle cell with Faith for a Cure.
Absolutely.
And in doing that, we are proud to say that there is a curative out there. Mm-hmm. Now, we're not saying we did it, but we're saying that to get behind an initiative like that and be a part of that process and actually see manifestation, we believe Faith for a Cure is bigger.
Right.
So we believe that we can cure this poverty thing that's happening out here in Northwest too by partnering and doing what we're doing. So 5'10 is in honor of him, mm-hmm. was his birthday, whereas like I just said, if 5,000 people mm-hmm. will actually buy tickets to the concert series,
mm-hmm.
that will now populate this area mm-hmm. with people down here to have fun and enjoy, learn about our culture, hear some good music. You're going to hear hip-hop, R&B, go-go, maybe some gospel. You're going to hear all the genres,
mm-hmm.
genres that has come from our soul music. We got all of that.
And the food.
All that stuff to come down here, the food, the designs. You're going to have, you know, the design district's going to be open with different boutiques and stuff out there. Jewelry, all these people is going to be out here.
Mm-hmm.
Artists like Bryce Cobb's work and stuff being out here. So it's going to be an awesome experience to have 5,000 people actually moving around down here doing that. But then we know that there's some people who want to help that are all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
And they might be able to be that 5,000 to come in. So we want
exactly.
10,000 people to give $100.
Mm-hmm.
If 10,000 people, which I got 5,000 Facebook friends, and then you add up my other social medias, I got 10,000 friends myself,
mm-hmm.
that if everyone gave $100, we got $1 million in this district, in this area
uh-huh.
that will allow for us to, now we don't have to get frustrated at the restaurants when we go there because now they've had some help
mm-hmm.
to get what they need so they can have better service so they look comparable to some of the major chains and
Absolutely.
Things like that. So the 5'10 is coming.
Love it. It's not just about one person, it's about everybody.
We give, son.
So, love it. All right, any shout-outs you want to give?
Shout-out to 7-Eleven, because that's why I say, that's why I'm shout-out to 7-Eleven. Because you got to evolve daily, man. These, now what, 7-Eleven, you got so many convenience stores and stuff that's coming open now that you don't know who's out there. But 7-Eleven was the store I first learned how to play video games and stuff at it. Now they, in this era, they selling so many of their own products that they about to be 7-Eleven, you can just come get 7-Eleven stuff now. And so they got their own water, they got their own chips, they got everything. Big shout out to 7-Eleven.
Shout cookies, out to 7-Eleven.
And Roller Food.
Oh, yeah, I love Roller Food.
But I always love to leave you out by saying that thing inside you, man. It's not a dream, it's your purpose. Set your sights on your targets, hit them, because the only one who can stop you is you. Once you truly start to believe in that thing and walk in your act of faith, God will allow it to manifest. And I promise you, it's not something I heard. It's something we're living every day and so grateful for it. Being able to broadcast live, that's right, Star City Clothing. Star City Clothing all day. Out to the world, man. Focus Radio, man. You're doing awesome. Hey, you, listen, and I don't even want to do.
My show ended like 5 minutes ago.
I don't even want to do shows because you're doing so great with the show. The Daily Grind, man. Make sure y'all telling people about it, man. Like, share, tell her. Encourage her, man, to keep doing the thing. Because we love you in this. We love having you back in the city, too. Yeah, man.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, man.
Until tomorrow, everybody. God bless.